All right, this is a TV Tan podcast, episode 0314, I believe.
Oh, are we starting right now? Are we live?
Sure, why not?
Start, I'll go the puck inside, so I'm not around the train.
We'll go ahead and start it. This is a whole new frontier for TV Tan, a three-way.
Oh, phrasing?
No, not at all, no. We have the king of burgers, Goots, out there.
Yep. Four-time belt champion.
Yeah, and there's Tommy Milagro over there,
and that is Bill Frost, who is huddled and nestled safely, practicing social distancing in the Outlaw Studios in Sosala.
Yeah, I've been in lockdown for going on 4 weeks now, I think, something like that.
I hear you, Bill. I hear you. I'm like, since the 13th of whatever last month was.
Yeah.
And I'm a little pissed that people aren't respecting it.
Well, I am, goddammit. And this week's episode brought to you by Outlaw Distillery, right?
Oh, yes. And let us make sure that everybody understands that in these tough times, and Goots, I'm sure you'll talk about it in a second, we should not only respect social distancing, but we should also respect the hard workers, the true essential workers of this new orange order, and that is the people that bring us the fine spirits like Outlaw Distillery. Now, Outlaw Distillery, again, a fine sponsor who has brought us the bourbon, whiskey. They brought us the rum, the spiced rum, the coffee rum, the white whiskey, but as I am here huddled into my little domicile, I have got straight corn whiskey.
Huh.
It's one of their new flavorings.
I have not had that.
It just came out a couple of months ago. Goots, have you had a chance to try that?
No, I haven't checked anything of their shit out other than lately I've been really wanting to get some hand sanitizer from them. I don't know why.
Well, I'll bring it up near the end of the episode. They don't have
the
hand sanitizer.
Sounds good, and that might be a culture's item, brother.
Indeed, and I'm here to tell you right now, having the corn whiskey is just—it's like getting your vegetables and having hand sanitizer for your inside.
Aww.
It's just lovely. But definitely,
honestly, as long as you got the hand sanitizer, the inside, you know,
yes,
keeps us clean.
Yes, and you can visit them still in Midvale. They are dealing with sales of their fine products, and they are practicing social distancing here and wiping shit down.
All right.
So please frequent them, and please, please, of all things that are holy, folks, tell them TV Tan Podcast sent you.
Oh, yes, please. Now more than ever. And
yes.
we've got to get the word out to our dozens of listeners out there. And
Well, you might get a couple dozen when you got the kid tonight.
That's true, yes.
Oh, we are in the presence of royalty.
Yeah.
And I think we should. Oh, do you want to start off there, Bill?
Well, I'm gonna blast through the new stuff you can watch this week because you know, you're stuck in front of the TV, right? And so there's plenty of new stuff coming out this week still. So I'm gonna blast through it before we get to the monster of all wrestling reports here.
God!
On Monday, April 6th, the day this episode drops, Quibi, a new streaming platform, launches. It's basically designed for your phone. It's a whole lot of 10-minute episodes of about 50 shows they're going to be premiering over the next few weeks here. They're dropping about 25 of them on Monday. We have a Chrissy Teigen show where she's basically playing Judge Judy. We have Chance the Rapper hosting a new version of Punk'd. We have a new version of The Most Dangerous Game starring Liam Hemsworth. And, Liam.
Miley's ex?
The smaller Hemsworth. The still good looking, but smaller Hemsworth.
You mean the one from 300?
Maybe. I don't know.
The one that gave away that the 300 were coming? I'm sorry.
It could have been him, yeah. But here's the show I'm most interested in. It's a Murder House Flip.
Oh.
Okay. We've been joking about a show like that forever, and now it's a reality. It's really happening. Murder House Flip.
And wow.
Coming up on Tuesday, April 7th, Tuning Out the News, that is T-O-O-N, out the news on CBS All Access. This is from a Stephen Colbert and the our cartoon president people. It's a new, again, 5 to 7 minute segments that will culminate into a full episode. It's basically fake news in cartoon form with some real people. It's confusing, but it'll be, it'll give you something to laugh at.
Can't be as confusing as what I just saw on WrestleMania Night 2, but spoiler alert.
Weird thing at all. That was a full story.
Yeah. Also coming up on Tuesday, April 7th, the series finale of Schitt's Creek. Sad to see that go. Maybe now I'll catch up on it. And the season 3 premiere on TBS of The Last OG with Tracy Morgan and Tiffany Haddish.
Oh.
Very funny show.
You should be watching that a lot harder nowadays.
Yeah.
You have no excuse.
Yeah. Coming up on Wednesday, April 8th, Modern Family series finale. Oh, no. What's Ty Burrell going to do now?
Well, he's going to help save Utah.
True.
That's what he's going to fucking do.
Well, no, don't even talk about that. I'm an actual bartender, lost their job 4 weeks ago, and that Ty Burrell is a lottery. It's a lottery. If you look into it, they're giving out 40 bars. Yeah, let's not talk about it.
Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
It's a lottery. They're going to pick 40 bars from all the downtown bars and then give them some money to then let the owners pick 5 employees. Thank God it's originally 5 employees that work there. But now it's cool what Ty Burrell's doing, but I don't like how it's a lottery.
Okay. Yeah.
I don't know if many people looked into that, and I love what's going on. But me, as a bartender who is intended to get this, it's a lottery.
So it's like the Hunger Games.
It is. And I'm sorry to pipe in on that unscripted, but yeah.
As opposed to the
script. No.
As opposed to the script
that
we have.
Exclusive
report. Burrell is fucked bars downtown. And,
okay.
No, it is a good one.
This is something we didn't know. This is important news. Coming
it
up
is, and I'm on the in on that one because I've been like, I'll take a $500. It's a $500 check for bartenders, but it's a lottery when one gets them,
right?
For the most part.
All right. Well, first of all, may the odds be ever in your favor, and secondly, because we are in the midst of royalty here, please, for all our dozens of listeners, no, truly, bow down to your king and offer tribute, as it were.
Coming up on
tenants held. I'm sorry that I pipe in when I'm not supposed to, but it is royalty.
Hey,
woo!
It's totally cool. Coming up on Friday on Netflix, a new series of Bruise Brothers. It's a comedy, no laugh track. It's from the people behind The League. It's basically about a pair of brothers opening a brew pub. I can't remember.
Okay,
I'm trying to remember the last brew pub I went to. I believe it was Level Crossing, and it was good. But it's been a minute.
I remember going to breweries.
I remember
what it was like to be social
mm-hmm.
and not being hanging out in my room.
Yeah.
Well, we're being pretty social. I love this, you guys. This brings the neighborhood in.
And,
Thank you, sir.
And here's one I've been using to shut the brain off with. This premiered a couple of weeks ago. I forgot to mention it. Making the Cut, the new Project Runway, but not really, from Heidi Klum and Tim Gunn. It's on Amazon Prime Video.
Can I actually agree with you on that one, Bill? It actually looks like that the Project Runway lost their flair, and Heidi and this other older gay gentleman have started their own show, and it's going to fucking blow Project Runway out the water.
Well, it already is, because the first four episodes of air, they're doing two a week, and it looks like the budget just dwarfs Project Runway, for one thing. So it's like it's a high budget show, and it's so far pretty high quality too. Coming up on Sunday, season 3 of Killing Eve on BBC America. If you haven't seen this show, I would recommend checking out the first two seasons on Hulu. It's really cool, and it deserves all the hype it's getting. It's doing Breaking Bad numbers almost.
What?
Wow.
Yeah.
That's because people are home, or do you think that?
Well, it was doing those kind of numbers before this all happened. So, it's up there. Also,
I know Breaking Bad had big numbers. That's for sure.
Killing Eve is up there. getting closing in on it. Also, season 4 of Insecure, starring Issa Rae on HBO on Sunday. Very funny show. And a new series called Run, starring Merritt Weaver and from Godless and Nurse Jackie and Domhnall Gleeson from Star Wars, The Rise of Skywalker.
Okay.
It's a romantic comedy thriller, and I don't want to give too much away, but it is co-produced by Phoebe Waller-Bridge of Fleabag fame.
What was that again? It was Killing Eve, and what was the other one?
Killing Eve on Sunday, also Insecure on HBO, okay. Issa Rae, season 4, and a new series called Run, co-produced by Phoebe Waller-Bridge of Fleabag.
Got it.
Yeah.
Okay.
And, I'd also recommend the new season of Future Man. I already blasted through it last night on Hulu.
Okay.
People have been telling me to watch Future Man.
Future Man is great.
Well, you've got time to do it, so I would say watch it.
I think I might have to.
And now I'm going to throw it to sports. Get ready.
Oh, well, please, sir, hit the music.
And sports with Tommy Malandro. Go team.
From the sports desk of TV 10 podcast, Supersized Edition, we bring you to the granddaddy of them all, the sport of professional wrestling, WrestleMania edition. So first, I must thank our good King Gooch for deigning to bestow upon us his prestige. So he's going to take care of...
I could no further do it with none other than the Lucid Luchador himself, the best tag team in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, watch out for the Lucid Luchador and King Gooch in your neighborhood coming soon. Yes, I love that WrestleMania. Tonight, you know what? That was the entertainment I needed.
Yes.
Honestly, it was.
Now, a couple things we should bring up before we get into WrestleMania. Quick news here. As we are reporting live on air from our respective bunkers, as you all know, the state of Florida has issued a stay at home. So the WWE Performance Center closed for good. And
well, obviously, this is no new news. This happened like 2 weeks ago. We all know that WrestleMania was pre-recorded. Let's beat the bag out of the bush and get the kitty out of the bag. Yeah,
Raising.
Boom. Was pre-recorded.
Yeah, so now I am going to take care of night one highlights, and our good man King Gooch will take care of night two. Starting off with night one, let's just get it out of the way. Gronk was there as the host, but he wasn't that bad.
You know what? Gronk was sponsored by none other than, I got to throw in nameless promotions, but yes, it was Pit Viper. I've been working with that company for years, and to get your special TV Tan podcast account, use code Gooch Rules, GUTZRULES, for a 20% discount, and look like Gronk. Never like Gronk more until that night.
Oh, God, this is awesome already. But thank you for that, and let's be honest, folks, Gooch is more stylish than Gronk. Gooch greater than Gronk.
Like, did I give him those shades? And no, I didn't, but I did give him the discount Gooch Rules at pitviper.com.
So let me just blaze through some of the highlights of the matchup. Shayna Baszler was defeated by the man, Becky Lynch, Raw.
The match was a little meh, but I'm not a huge Shayna Baszler fan. There are a lot of people that are. I'm not. I'm a huge Becky Lynch fan. Decent match.
Could set up for some bigger matches down the road when the world goes back to normal.
They're probably going to wipe Shayna Baszler out, like they're going to wipe out a lot of superstars. But
yes, but that brings us now to the two sleeper matches of the evening: Intercontinental Championship match, Sami Zayn versus Daniel Bryan.
Great match. Great puck. I love how they presented it. I loved that they had both guys with clicks. I won't say that they're actually stables. You know, they're just kind of homies at the moment. But yeah. I love it.
And that brings us to the other sleeper match that I didn't expect, the SmackDown Tag Team match, which was really interesting because no tag teams, partly because the tag team.
I was freaking out about that. Like, I actually, you know, this before we went hardcore on our groups, but I was talking to somebody, and I'm like, how are they doing tag teams on a trace match with only one person?
Well, part of that has to do with the fact that, as reported before at the sports desk, The Miz had to withdraw because he was sick, which also...
I missed that.
Yeah, it's okay. You weren't there for the sports desk. It's what happens when you miss staff meeting. I forgive you. No, but the point is, the match was unique because one half of each respective tag team from The New Day and Usos and John Morrison of Miz and Morrison were involved. And Morrison,
yeah, I did his little dance.
Yeah, Morrison carried the match, won the match, but in a ladder match,
which was unique. I really liked the ending. I gotta say, at first you're like, "What the f just happened?" But then you're like, "That motherfucker just pulled both belts down."
Yes,
I like it. I like.
Oh, yeah. If this doesn't give him a singles push, I don't know what will. The other big matchup: Kevin Owens, Seth Rollins. Just sold drama. It was a straightforward match, and of course, Owens won with the disqualification, but then Owens said, fuck you, we are going to do a no-holds-barred match, and went for the insane spot,
saved the fucking night, it saved the night.
Yes.
Because we were all sitting here like, you are going to tell me they're going to DQ a match at Mania? Because remember, this is WrestleMania.
Anything can happen. And they did.
They needed to do that because Kevin Owens is a badass, and that proved a reason why he is.
The reason he's a badass is because, for those of you that didn't see it, Kevin Owens went from, in the WWE Performance Center, off the WrestleMania sign, which is a good 20, 30 feet high, onto Rollins on the announce table.
35 feet onto a steel table with cameras all over the place.
Right. And that brings us now to Goldberg versus Braun Strowman. Braun Strowman won. Moving on.
It was such a lame match. I mean, I love Braun Strowman, and it truly has the belt, and there's no reason why Goldberg should have ever even got the belt from the Fiend, but whatever. We'll talk about the Fiend later because it's so good what they did with the Fiend. But I'm glad his hands got the goddamn belt because that's cool. But Goldberg, fucking, why did you even do this? It's Saudi Arabia. They had to go to Saudi Arabia and give Goldberg the belt for the money in Saudi Arabia, and now they had to get rid of it. Well, how about a worthless match?
Yes, which now brings us to the highlight of night one, the Boneyard match. That was
Boneyard
Undertaker.
Match is good, dude. Boneyard
Undertaker,
match
AJ Styles. Oh, and Bill.
And I loved how they brought the OC in. I loved how they brought the OC in.
Well, for everybody that hasn't seen that match yet, and Bill, because I know you haven't, imagine if John Carpenter decided to book the match between AJ Styles and Undertaker.
Like a Jason.
Okay.
What's the John Carpenter movie with Roddy?
Michael Myers, Halloween.
No.
They Live?
Roddy Piper.
They Live?
They Live, exactly. Oh. Where they have that alleyway fight for like...
Cripple fight.
Match. The John Carpenter, fight. They Live alley match was... Great. It was like, that's why I like the Undertaker matches, because you're right, it is John Carpenter-ish, but it was more like They Live, especially where, like, I'm super about They Live at the moment.
Yes, which now brings us to day two, which is tonight, Sunday, as we're broadcasting live on air. Dudes,
Tommy,
take it away.
Why don't you keep rolling, because you know the matches better than I do. Keep going.
All right, and again, I'm just going to keep it brief here. I don't want
to MK this. Like, I don't know. I didn't know we were doing a goddamn podcast 5 minutes after. Honestly, I'm going to buy, if still possible, WrestleMania, because it will be the first WrestleMania I sat front row.
Talk about that for a minute while I'm pulling up my notes.
No, honestly, they're selling seats. Usually they sell seats for events for WWE does. That's part of your VIP package. You get to take home the chair. Well, I sat front row for WrestleMania this year, and I want to. I want a chair from it. A chair.
They're WWE.com
to find them.
Yeah, and they've been. Oh, sorry. Go on.
No, I'm just kidding. Yeah.
Well, I should point out that WWE has been a little bit clever that they have had T-shirts where they said.
Working on these chairs this whole week, like getting a chair. And at first, like days before when they mentioned it, they weren't available, so it was like they were sold out. And then I looked into it, and they're like pre-sell. And any time there's a pre-sell, means they need to be made. You know, they're gonna pre-sell these chairs for like months because I don't think anybody's making them right now, so. I have a feeling they'll be available for a moment. But I want a chair from the front row WrestleMania I sat front row for.
God damn it, yes.
This was an amazing WrestleMania.
I do have a WrestleMania question here.
Tombstone match and the Firefly match. This is the reason why. I'll tell you what. The reason why I got back into wrestling is because of Lucha Underground. And it's because they took a different way. They did, like, scripted movie BS, you know, in between true wrestling matches, which is kind of what we watched in WrestleMania right here. Like, we watched Brock Lesnar and the two big guys fuck out of each other. But then we watched these wacky-ass tells of our people we like Undertaker. I love The Undertaker. I don't want to see him in a match in a ring where he looks like an old man and gets taken down in 2 seconds like Goldberg did. I want to see this fake shit where it's like he's an old man and he's going to kill you. He's in his graveyard. You're with The Undertaker. And then you get the Firefly stuff that it's like Firefly left, right, left, right.
We're kind of getting too ahead of ourselves, but there is a question here.
I have a WrestleMania question here. Two nights. Is that unusual?
Yes.
Well, absolutely. It's once in a lifetime thing ever.
Because I was watching a lot of social media posts on Saturday night, thinking, wait a minute, I thought this thing was on Sunday.
Yep.
Are people time traveling? What the hell?
Well, they put breaking it into two nights is weird, but they got to pump out 9 hours of entertainment doing that. And so WWE was on a very strict, if any leaks are released, we will fire you on the spot.
Yep.
Okay.
All of this is pre-recorded. So they never let anybody know what event, what match was happening on what night. So like last night, we all watched and didn't know who was coming on. Until, like, the very last match, and then they showed us what was happening tonight, which is Sunday, the second night.
Okay.
You know.
And that brings us to the segue tonight, too, here. And I'm going to try to steamroll through this here. The big matches here, Rhea Ripley versus...
Charlotte Flair. Awesome match, but...
Got the W and the belt, and she is your new... NXT Women's Champion.
Exactly. New Women's Champion. Her, they call it her now 11-time champion. She now
pretty much.
Time?
Well,
I consider her that. I'm a king. She's royalty. Royalty bequeath royalty. She's an 11-time champion.
Yes, and the other entertaining match of the night, Otis Dojovic versus Dolph Ziggler.
My boy Otis.
imagine Georgie Animal Steel versus Macho Man Randy Savage 2.0. That is all you need to know. But this time, Otis gets the girl in Mandy Rose, that sweet little peach.
A big guy gets the way and gets the blonde.
Giving us hope for us schlubs, this schlub here. And it gives
us all a... shot in hell. You mean there's a chance?
Yes. And let's see. Oh, and the other news story, Gronkowski, he is your new 24/7 WWE
champion. I missed that one. I must have missed that one. I was out
smoking when it happened. I must have missed it. I must have missed it because I had the whole Pit Viper discount ready to roll.
Oh.
Get him this one. Come back in and people are like, he's 24 champion. And I knew he was going to get it, but I was waiting for the chance.
Which brings us now to the top three matches for the evening here. The others, I'm going to skip ahead because, blink. You didn't miss much. But Randy Orton versus Edge, last man standing match. They brawled all over the Performance Center. Told a great story, a bit long.
Great match, but great story, but I also feel it went a bit long. But, you know.
How this is going to play down the road when things go back to normal is to say, but Edge has not lost a step in the 9 years he's been away from WWE. Kudos to Randy Orton for delivering. Yeah, which I'm going to get to in a second here. And the next matchup was John Cena versus Bray Wyatt in a funhouse match. And the only way I can describe it, because Goots and I were watching this and commenting, it's as if David Lynch booked this match. I mean, we went Twin Peaks in this here, Bill Frost.
Okay. You're not even a wrestling fan. If you like these TV shows that are out, and I'm not saying TV shows are stupid, I'm playing the hell apart, but if you like freaky ass, your mind TV shows, everybody's like, did you do acid? And I'm like, of course I did. To get this show, literally this, I think it went probably around 30 minutes, which is cool.
Okay.
Because that's like a full episode, because I was watching the time. But I think from start time to finish, it was amazing, man.
Yeah.
There's going to be bootleg footage of, if not, WWE needs to put it out tomorrow. The Firefly Funhouse match was mind-blowing, and mind-fuckery is what it was. It's not mind-blowing, it's mind-fuckery, if we can say that. If we can say that.
And I'm going to chime in with 2 points. And the chat watch session that Goots and I were in, one of the guys commented, you know, I've never done an acid trip, but now after seeing this, I don't need to. And
haven't. It's kind of close. That's what it's like, you're not doing acid. You know, no, it's kind of close.
Okay.
It makes you really think about what the fuck you're doing.
Yes. And I think the best way to sum that up was by WWE superstar Titus O'Neil, who commented with only a face he could do, I don't know what we just watched.
Well, yeah, that's thing. Then Titus came back, and that's after Gronk was gone. I missed the 24/7 on the Gronk shit. I missed the fucking thing.
Then this is the thing.
If you got a PitViper.com, I'm going to put on that shit, and I'll give you a 20% discount. Use my name.
Which brings us finally to the main event. It was against the Scottish Psychopath, Drew McIntyre, against the reigning, defending, conquering champion, Brock Lesnar. Sorry, I didn't draw it out that long, but we got so much time.
I was hoping it go longer. I was just kicking in. I hate watching the shit by myself because I'm sitting there yelling all the chants.
Point taken.
Like even Sami Zayn, I'm like,
can be said here, despite all the F5s and despite all the claymores, Drew McIntyre is now your new Universal.
No, wait. I was out smoking on that one and I missed it. So between two nights, two championship belts were exchanged over maybe 16 moves.
Mm-hmm.
That may be the negative about this WrestleMania.
I will say this much here, being as objective as I am.
Last night there were 8 moves in the fucking Goldberg Strowman match. There were 4 F5s and 4 spears. Tonight, I wasn't counting, but if we go back to our group, somebody was. I can't go back. But it was a great WrestleMania.
Yeah.
And the title matches didn't mean shit to me.
Yes, it was all about the scripted violence, I think is the biggest takeaway here. The cinematic violence.
I'm glad we're on the TV Tan podcast for it, because, like,
even people that aren't wrestling people, go back and watch, as we say, the Tombstone match from Undertaker, and go back and watch the Firefly match. For you people that are non-wrestling people listening to this, go watch those. They will be on YouTube or whatever. Well, they will make you like, this is the perfect time for wrestling to do this.
Well, based on these reports, I am definitely going to go check these matches out.
Yeah. Oh, God. The big of this WrestleMania match, and please, I as the objective journalist that I am, and as your lucid luchador.
Okay. Lucid luchador.
Thank you. I will say Boneyard match and Funhouse are the biggest takeaways of this very interesting WrestleMania.
People like Bill, who aren't wrestling people, go back and watch the fucking thing with The Undertaker. It'll be 10 minutes of, it'll seem to you like independent movie stuff, which it is. It's WWE. Yeah.
I'm going to check it out.
But then the next night they come at you with this Firefly Funhouse match. Oh, yeah, that's exactly what we needed. Not only is it funny and fun for what it is, it took my mind off of everything. And also, it really builds these characters back up. Like, we watched The Undertaker. He's a 70-year-old man. We've watched him for the last year and a half put these shows on because people pay him. And it's like, you're old. Don't do that. If you produce a movie thing like they're doing, it's cool because then you're like, oh, yeah, you don't fuck with The Undertaker. And same thing with the Firefly Funhouse match. They went into John Cena's mind. We got to see every version of John Cena. Give me a break. That was awesome.
We're going to try to deliver this to all our social media platforms. And why are we doing this? Because we know you're self-contained and social distancing, but we will still do it because...
Well, we are. I want fans to know, and I want non-fans. That's the whole thing. Like, I'm sure fucking not everybody's a fan of wrestling, but if you at least take and look at these things, you got nothing else to do. We're all sitting at home, so...
Yeah.
You know, it's not a wrestling match. It's like a 5 to a 15-minute movie.
And more importantly, King Goots, it's sports.
It's sports with Tommy Malagro and King Goots. Go team!
Thank you!
Okay, I got a couple things to wrap up on here.
Stadium shaking.
I got a couple of things to wrap up on here. First of all, Louis C.K.
He's back.
Louis C.K. has a new special you can buy for $7.99. Not a sponsor. At louisck.com, and it's called Sincerely Louis C.K. And he talks a little bit about, you know, the whole jerking off in front of people thing a little bit. This was recorded early in March of this year in Washington D.C. So if you're still a Louis fan and you got to see him, Go give him $8, and there you go. But also,
now how is this out on the platforms here, man? I'm sorry.
Well, far as I can tell, what I'm reading here is, let's see, where can you get this thing now? Apparently, you email him $7.99, and then you get a code, and you go to his website, I believe, louisck.com.
Oh, really? So you actually have to seek him out?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I don't think it's widely out there on all the platforms. I think you got to specifically go to his site to get it.
Well, that's the reason I'm asking is because of this Twitter tweet that I saw that said Louis C.K. releasing a special when no one can leave the room feels pretty on brand, to be honest.
Very on brand, yeah. And also, I have one for Melissa Merlot. Should she be listening out there? She probably already knows about this show. I just want to make sure. It's new on the History Channel, called the Secret of Skinwalker Ranch. It's a new It's a new alien hunting reality series. Filmed right here in Utah, over UFO Alley in the Uinta Basin, Skinwalker Ranch.
Oh, I'm from the Uinta Basin. Is that with an H or an A?
That is with an A.
Yeah, I always joke with people. Though, I graduated from Uinta High. And you know what? That had an H.
Yeah, this is a mildly interesting new Alien Hunter show. And the secret of these shows is you got to have some big personalities hunting around and finding a lot of nothing for the most part. And unfortunately, there's no one.
Tigers in it. There's no tigers.
There's no tigers for one thing. Yeah.
They probably have a lot more people watching.
Yeah. Yeah. There's no over the top personalities in this show. So it's not.
Well, you got a goose here with you now.
Yeah. I mean, you're a native. You should be hosting this thing.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
New thing, TV Can.
So if they do make it to season two, we're gonna start a petition to get Goots on this show.
Absolutely,
goddamn better. That'll bring some listeners.
Yeah. So more UFO nonsense, and also want to wrap up with this coming on Hulu on Wednesday, a movie that I'm gonna have to give another chance because I wasn't into it the first time around. Parasite will be available on Hulu on Wednesday.
I don't know if we need that in these times here, man.
True, yeah. But
it's like me wanting to watch Tiger King, which ain't fucking happening. I'm sorry.
I mean, you haven't watched Tiger King?
No, and I'm going to hold out as long as I can.
You need to watch it because photos of Goose are about to come out. Tiger King.
Yeah.
I need my tag team partner with me.
One of the mulleted whack jobs in that series is hinting at that Netflix might be dropping
us. I don't like that term, mulleted whack job. I don't know if I like that term or not. Mulleted whack job.
Well, I'm not referring to you. Mulleted. You're a mulleted upstanding citizen of society.
Okay, thank y'all.
There's a distinction here.
Yeah,
fucking Carol Baskin, so.
Yeah.
JK.
Yeah, so allegedly a new episode, Unseen or a new or something, Tiger King episode will be dropping this week. Only a rumor. I don't know if that's for real or not.
You know they got several seasons of that shit. Have you honestly watched any of it?
I watched the whole damn thing in one night.
Okay. Yeah, Tommy, have you watched it?
No, I have not. But
you
now,
idiot, you need to watch.
I would not recommend. I would not recommend watching it all in one sitting.
It's fucked up as shit. But they all want David Spade to fucking play
Joe Dirt,
the Tiger King.
Yeah.
But once you see it, you will be like, Goots needs to play the Tiger King.
Absolutely. So, in addition to the film docudrama. Of Tiger King, Goots will be starring in that, and also he will be hosting.
Shall we say, Tiger in the Room?
Yeah, he will be hosting also the second season of Secret of Skinwalker Ranch. So he's going to have a busy 2021.
They're going to do like four shows on this Joe Exotic. They're going to do like a get him out of goddamn jail. They're going to do like a Carol Baskin. There's going to be like four series on Joe Exotic.
It's a whole franchise.
Oh yeah. And this is the title of our episode, Tiger in the Room. So thank you.
All right, we're going to wrap it.
Because guess whose mullet is longer than anyone else's?
Could it be yours, my leech?
We're going to wrap it. We're going to wrap it. This has been episode 0314 of the TV Tan podcast. Outlaw Distillery brought us the booze. Also, we want to thank our other fine sponsors, Sugar House Distillery, Ogden Zone, Bohemian Brewery, and the Booze Teak. You can get a hand sanitizer through most of them.
Check out at Goots Rules on Instagram.
Goots Rules, Instagram. And
the unofficial sponsor of TV Tan podcast at this point, Pit Vipers, where you can get a 20% discount. Be sure to do King Goots?
Use the code Goots Rules. And this is very disapproved by Pit Viper, but you are the unofficial sponsor by.
Cool.
Yes, Goots Rules, 20% off.
All right.
And that's GUTZ, as in Zulu, Rules, RULES. That is the promo code.
Sure.
A hidden code that not many people. The more I have it, the more I'm like, damn, that's a good discount.
Cool. All right, we will be probably back next week, far as I know, And we'll
hopefully we're back next week. Don't say probably. Now we'll be back.
Okay, we'll be back next week.
Maybe not. But we got to stand for humanity, and we will all be here.
All right, say goodnight, America.
Good night, America.
Good night, America.
And jiggle that handle, my king, because it's time to...